B.V. Ramana, teaching English. In this video, I would like to share with you the topic Types of Finite Clauses. There are two important types. One is main clause, another is subordinate clause. Main clause is the clause which has one subject and one finite verb. Example, I was a boy. And subordinate clause is the clause which is a clause when it is introduced by a subordinator, it is called subordinate clause. That means the subordinator plus subject plus finite verb is called subordinate clause. Here the example is when I was a boy. So the difference between main clause and subordinate clause is the only the existence of a subordinator before a clause. If you want to know more about this main clause and subordinate clause, a separate video was made marking main clause and subordinate clause. Well, now the types of subordinate clause. There are three important types of subordinate clause. What are they? First one is noun clause, and another one is the adjective clause, and third one is the adverb clause. All these three clauses are subordinate clauses. And then what is noun clause? Noun clause is the clause which does the work of a noun. Adjective clause is a clause which does the work of an adjective. Adverb clause is a clause which does the work of an adverb. If we teach like this, our children may not in a position to understand, may not in a position to identify it. Then some clues are there for each class. What are the clues? Second one. Noun class answers the question word what. This is important one. Adjective class has an antecedent before the class. And third one, this adverb class answers the WH words other than what. That means that it may answer when, it may answer where, it may answer why, it may answer how, like it. But it doesn't answer what. So whenever the clause answers other than what WH words, then it is called adverb clause. If you make the children know about these three points, then the child consent will be feel very comfortable to identify these three clauses. Let us see in the examples how these rules work. Now, first one, example number one. I know where he lives. Here, this clause answers the question word what. For example, I know what. The answer is where he lives. So it is called noun clause. Second one. I know the place where he lives. Here, where he lives describes the antecedent, that is place. So, it is an adjective clause, second rule. Well, here the difference between these two sentences is only the existence of an antecedent. Here there is no antecedent, here the antecedent is there. So, here when we write, I know the place where he lives is an adjective clause because it has this clause as an antecedent to which this clause describes. So, this is the second rule. And third one, you go where he lives. Here, this answers the question not what. This answers the question what. That is, rather than the what. That means, it may be when, where, why, how. Here, what does it answer? You go where he lives. So it answers the question word where. So this is an adverb clause. If it had answered the question word what, it would have been noun clause. But this clause answers the question word where. So it is called adverb clause. Well, let us look at the second example. He believed what? So it answers the question, this clause answers the question word what. That means when we say we believe that he played with them, then the clause that he played with them is a noun clause because it answers the question word what. Look at this second one. We like the game that he played with them. So here, that he played with them is common in both these sentences. But this class has an adjective before it. That means this class describes this noun, that is adjective. So it is called adjective. So by adjective, we learned that it is an adjective class. And third one, we are happy that he played with them. Here, that he played with them, it answers the question word why. Why are we happy that we played, that he played with them is the answer. So here, this class answers the question word why, not what. So this is called adverb class. Well, friends, we can have some more practice with some more examples. Well, example number 3. I can't understand when he behaves strangely. Here, we can ask the question with what. I can't understand what. The answer is when he behaves strangely. So, this class answers the question word what. So, it is a noun class. Here, I know the time when he behaves strangely. Here, this class describes this adjective, that is a noun which goes before it. So it is called adjective class. The rule is that whenever there is an adjective before a class, it is called adjective class. Here, don't meet him when he behaves strangely. Here, this class answers not the question word what, but here it answers the question word when. So it is called adverb class. So a class when answers the question word other than what, then it is called adverb class. So here it answers the question word when. So it is called adverb class. Well, example number 4. We can't guess. What can't we guess? Where you would like to live. So here, this class answers the question word what. So it is a noun class. And next one, we can't guess the place where you like to live. Here, where you like to live is a class which describes a noun before it. That means it has an adjective before it. So it is called adjective class. And third one, you can go where you like to live. You can go where. So this class answers the question word where, not what. If a class answers the question word other than what, then it is called adverb class. So here this class answers the question word where. So it is an adverb class. And next one, he explains how it works well. He explains what. So here, how it works gives the answer for the question word what. So it is a noun class. He explains the way how it works well. Here this class, how it works well, describes its adjective, that is the way. So it is called adjective class. He buys it as it works well. Why does he buy it? Because as it works well is the answer. So here the class doesn't give the answer for question word what. Then it gives the answer for why. So whenever it answers the question word other than what, then it is called adverb class. I know why he worked hard. I know what. So it gives the answer why he worked hard. So why he worked hard answers the question word what. So it is noun class. Here, I know the reason why he worked hard. Here, why he worked hard describes its adjective, that is reason. So it is called adjective class. And he passed. Why? Because he worked hard. Here, because he worked hard answers the question word why. So it is called here adverb class. Friends, in this way, when a class answers the question word what, it is a noun class. A class which has an adjective before it, it is an adjective class. If a class describes, if a class answers the question word other than what, that means it may answer when, where, why, how, like that, then the class concerned is called adverb class. Friends, if you like this video, please subscribe to my channel by tapping subscribe button on YouTube. This doesn't cost you anything, but it gives me an encouragement. Thank you very much for watching. Namaste.